Yeah, go down here, take a left, take another left, go about 10 blocks up there on your right.
Wait a minute, I can't hear you. Hold on a minute.
Go down here, take a left, go take another left. Go about 10 blocks, it's up there on your right.
That's where it is.
You ever hear of a place called Fat Willie's?
Yeah.
Is it on Bleecker Street?
I don't know. Hold on.
You live around here?
Why?
We're looking for something. We're looking to enjoy ourselves. We want to party.
What do you mean party?
Well, we just want to, nothing perverted. We just want to get ill, New York style. You know what I mean?
What the fuck are you talking about?
We want a cop.
You want a what?
We want to score some rum.
Hello, is Mr. Hillman there, please? Well, could you get your daddy on the phone? Mr. Hillman, my name is Rivers. Listen to me carefully. Tomorrow night at Aqueduct, the first race is going to be won by a horse named Sir Run Run Shane. Yes, that's your pony, Bet the Rent. Hello, Mr. Nan. Tomorrow night... Excuse me?
No, I'm not from the phone company. Listen to me. Aqueduct, McCann's Chance. Yes, McCann's Chance.
Hey, what's up, Rick?
Hey, man, how are you? What's going on?
Hey, Rick, this is Way. Hey,
everyone.
Hey there.
I've been talking to them, and they're all right, and they want to buy some rock.
Yeah?
And, they buy some rock, you got.
I don't know what you're talking about. What are you talking about?
Hey,
really. How much you want to get?
Grand.
1 grand.
Do all right, Rick.
All right, listen, I gotta go to the bathroom. I'll be back in a moment, okay?
Come on.
Well, I'll tell you this, you were very lucky to find me. Because you will not find stuff like this anywhere else. Rick is used to, you know, dealing in much larger quantities. You know, it lowers the risk.
Yeah, well, you know, if the shit's as good as you say it is, then we might be interested in a larger acquisition.
I'll ask Ricky, I'll see what's up, you know, because I think he's expecting a shipment coming in soon.
Fucking excellent.
Bust this out. You can call me when the shipment comes in. Now, you should make it sound like something else when you call on the phone, you know. You know, like I got the new albums just came in, or shipment of, like, sneakers or something, you know, in case somebody's listening.
Sure, that's a very good idea. Virginia, huh?
We gotta get out of here, man. You got the money?
Yeah.
There's cops all over this place. The guy in the back, I think he made me.
He's a cop?
Yeah. Listen, it's just better if you guys aren't seen with us, okay? Listen, it was nice to have met you, man.
Yeah,
okay?
Thanks.
All right, sure.
I gotta go, too.
Come on, we gotta go.
Wait a minute. We gotta test the product.
That's 89% pure, pal. If you ever have more than 30, I'd be surprised.
I gotta test it.
Not in here, man.
We gotta go. I'll talk to you next week.
No, we gotta test the product.
What, do you want the police lab to test it for you, asshole?
Listen, asshole, man, where does that it's come? Just a little hot right now, okay? We gotta go.
Hey, fuck you, man. You have our money.
Listen to me, my bitch. I'm telling you, it's good.
Shut up. Listen, wait, late.
I'm sorry.
We gotta go, all right? I'll call you. You're in.
All right, you're
right.
We gotta go.
We gotta call us, because we were in.
You're in.
I see
I'll
it.
Call
right?
you. See I'll it. Call you. You're in.
You look like you're gonna fucking piss in your pants.
You know, he gave me his card.
Really, what does it say?
Wade Wilson, band management.
What a fucking joke. The question is this, are you gonna sleep or are you gonna fuck?
I won't sleep.
Are you gonna say, I'm sorry, man, but I'm too drunk?
No, I will not.
Well, therein lies a funny characteristic, Pete, between those that do, like me, like us, and those that don't, like everybody else.
The point is, 99% of the population would avoid assholes like that, but Junior seized the moment. It was fucking beautiful.
Thank you.
If it's fucking you want,
we're fuckers.
It's fucking you will get.
Every time you leave, every time you're gone, he's out running around, he's out to push him on. I don't care what you tell me, it's not right. Don't bother coming over, just call or spin on by.
I don't want to do lines. I want to do a damn W.
Because
that's my lane.
I want to do
pile. We're going to do a W. Taking the old fucking.
Oh, shit.
Come over here and do me.
Give me a shit.
Yeah. Get over there and have a bad time. You're in the bad time corner.
Yeah, good time, right
here. Oh, yeah.
Okay, it's my turn.
It's good, right?
It's fucking good.
Oh, fuck, shit.
Wanna know something? I got fired, like, just today.
Really? Well, good for you. The jobs are for regular fucking people. Clean the chicken, get the lids up here. I want this, I want that.
Bullshit.
Fuck that
job.
Shit.
Bullshit. Where you been, Angie? I haven't seen you in like a while.
I was in Florida for a couple months. You know? You were real good tonight, pal.
Thank you.
Welcome. That's what it's all about. Seizing the moment. You've been learning, buddy.
Yeah, it's just hard, you know, sometimes to get an angle, you know? Where's the end? You know, it's been really dead here lately. You know, if you know about anything, I'd love to work with you.
I may have something.
Wakey,
come on, get up.
We're gonna make a little money today.
Alright, what's going on?
Here, check this out. This is a list of the absolute most bottom-feeding compulsive gamblers which you can find.
What you can sell them? The mind boggles.
So what's the thing?
Okay, what you do? You pick a race with six horses. You pick the first horse and you call 10 people and give them a tip that that horse will win. Then you do the same thing for the second horse and so on and so on and so on. So 10 people will have gotten a winning horse, right? You call the winners back on the next day with a pony. You follow me?
Yeah.
You give them each a different pony, so by the end of 2 days, one sucker has gotten 2 correct tips in a row. And here's your mark. You got it?
Yeah. So let me guess, this sucker will pay you for the third tip.
That's correct.
How long have you been doing it?
For 2 days.
You got a mark?
Will in a minute. 2-2. Okay, look, the list says asshole, fool, loser, tuttle. Ted Fitzsimmons. Yes, Mr. Ted Fitzsimmons. It's your lucky day. Hello, Mr. Fitzsimmons. Yes, it's me again. Yes, the phone guy. Been at the track lately? Really? You won $300. That's nice. Listen. What's that? Oh, you wish you would have bet more. No, I can't tell you that. Listen to me carefully. Why not let's meet face to face?
Be inside at 5 after. I'm gonna give him a minimum of bullshit and I'm gonna get my money, okay? Now the race is gonna start around 3:25, okay? Now when you see me leave, you stay with him for a couple of minutes and make sure he doesn't follow me. And then you meet me back here, which should be about 3:20, 3:25. You got that?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, if anything gets weird, you can always call the cop. We haven't done anything traceably illegal. All right? You're here to watch my back. It's gonna be no problem.
Goddamn right there isn't. I'll be in there at 5 after.
Hey, why are we here?
We've come to fuck.
No problem. Hey, can I get a cup of coffee, please?
I'm Ted Fitzsimmons. Are you the phone guy?
Yes, I am. Call me Rick.
Coffee. Yeah, coffee.
When you do things, things happen. Now I have for you this most delightful news. Fuck you. You were not nice to me.
Did you bring my money?
Did you bring the information?
Yes, I did.
And it's going to win. You know this for a fact. There was no element of chance, no guesswork, because I cannot rely on any degree of fucking luck.
Ted, it's gonna win, okay?
Oh,
the race is in 20 minutes. Now, you'll have time to get to the OTB. My employer suggests, for the sake of appearances, you do not bet any more than you reasonably can account for.
Reasonably account for? Wild flock. Wild flock. Are you sure?
Where's the rest of my money?
Wild flock. Aqueduct. Fifth race.
Wait. What is this bullshit? $50. Where's the rest of my money?
You will get it after I've won.
Oh. I'm gonna have you fucking killed. You understand me? Fuck you.
Now, I am not going to be pushed around anymore, you fucking bastards.
It's all set, Ted. She put the money on Wild Flock. That's good for exactly that. All of it is good now.
This is a big mistake, Ted.
I'm going to move to Colorado.
Oh, that's nice. That's really nice.
Thank you.
Shut up.
Be quiet, Rick. I want to hear the race.
Listen to me. It might not work, Ted. I was supposed to call my employer and tell him that the bet was set. You wouldn't let me call him. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Shut up! You expect me to believe a story like that? Are you trying to put the hoodoo on me, you fucker?
Don't you try it. Sit down.
Calm down.
Sit down.
That'll be $11.25, sir.
I want it there by tomorrow.
It'll be there before 10 a.m. tomorrow. Thank you.
Can I get some stamps from you?
Please go to the end of the line.
Okay.
Change, sir.
Coming for the head of the turn, it's Lucky Feet overtaking Broken Lamp. A late move for Finding Sunshine crossing into third. Bubba Drew is fourth. Wild Clock running fifth. And Big Pebble is sixth.
Can I get some more
coffee? It's Lucky Feet ahead by two lengths. And the winner is Lucky Feet. Broken Lamp comes in second. Finding Sunshine places third.
Why would you do this, man?
Bubba Drew crosses fourth. Wild Flock holds on for fifth place. And Big Pebble is sixth.
I'm going to take you with me.
And Lucky Feet, the even money favorite, wins by two lengths. We'll be back with more excitement here at the Big A after this message.
Yo, agent, I'm sorry about...
What the fuck?
Where the fuck were you?
Wait, chill out, man.
You're not supposed to have my fucking back!
Hurry, yo, listen to me!
We're gonna be rich!
Okay, all right, let me just get this straight for me, okay? You had, who knows what, $1 million worth of drugs at your fingertips that you thought might be a good idea to send to some fucking town in Virginia. Jesus fucking Christ!
It's perfect.
And why they hate us?
Listen to me. I only had a split second. I had the card right in my pocket. His address. I slapped it on there. It's like you said, a split second window of opportunity. I made the switch.
Wow. And this took priority while I was being assaulted by a vicious band of fucking lumberjacks, right?
Listen to me. It's perfect. It totally works. Okay? Everyone knows you can't send drugs through the mail. It'll get traced back to you. But this is perfect. If the feds trace it, it's in Virginia, which is no connection to us.
Okay. Well, no connection. Let me tell you something about a place like Virginia, okay? They suck.
All we gotta do is go in there, get the drugs, and get the fuck out. In, bang.
They were very fucking big, Pete.
AJ, I'm sorry about the lumberjacks. We're gonna be rich.
All right, I'll stop. All right, Virginia's not that far. I think we can make it by morning.
Morning? Bullshit. Introduce yourself to El Jefe. 8 cylinders, American steel, pal.
Yeah, well, just don't wrap us around a tree. I want to live to spend my money.
Well, look. I took care of it. You tell them that.
You know, I listen to too much bullshit from you hard cases all day long.
Sent it in the mail. Had to, it was the only way.
You sent it in the mail?
Well, you don't want to, ideally, no, but it is done. It's done all the time. You know people are doing it. I sent it to a non-existent employee in a restaurant. The manager's gonna pick it up. It'll be there by 10. Everything's gonna be all right.
What did you buy here? Wild smoked sausage? You fucking idiot. Why don't you get some meat? What's wrong with you? You gotta pee?
I gotta pee. Hey.
I collect from Pete. Hey, Mom. Mom, yeah, it's me. Yeah, I know it's late. I'm sorry. Listen, I'm not gonna come home tonight. I'm staying over Bobby's in Jersey. Yeah, we're gonna paint some houses around there. Yeah, I just got it. I just found out. Okay? So I'll be back in a couple days, alright?
Wake up.
What's up?
We're here.
17 Benji Road.
What time is it?
A little before 6.
Just a few more hours.
Yeah, we look pretty goddamn unmistakably out of place in a car, Pete.
Who's gonna see us? There's nobody fucking around here. It's deserted. Just get some sleep. I'm up.
God, this I cannot stand. I can't stand this. I cannot stand this.
What?
This, I cannot stand this.
What?
Half the population has probably already seen us. A couple of derelicts sleeping in a car in a scumbag town like this. Do you know what they do when they see that, Pete? They call the police.
All right, take it easy, man. The worst comes to worst, we'll just say we pulled off the side of the highway to get some sleep or something.
Oh, that's brilliant. Well, I've had it.
Where you going?
If he's alone, I'm gonna kick his fucking ass. If he isn't, I'm gonna say we came back to apologize.
I'm coming.
You got your knife?
Yeah, I got my knife. That's exactly what I got. You got a knife too, AJ?
No. I'll nod my head. If you see me nod my head to you, you cut him up.
All right. Hold on. What do you mean?
You got a knife? Cut his fucking ass.
Cut his ass?
Yeah.
I mean, well, what do you mean? I mean, exactly. I mean, cut his ass to make him start screaming? Cut his ass till he dies? I mean, what exactly is the objective when you say cut his ass?
I mean, if he opens a door and open my mouth and his response is instantly hostile, he can't follow any linear train of thought, I will try to jump him. If he can't be subdued, I'll nod my head while he's punching me in the fucking face, and you just be ready there with your knife to cut his fucking ass, like you are my partner who's out there looking out for my best interest. Now, do you think you can do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
So the idea is I give him a flesh wound. He sees blood. It's his own. He freaks out. He runs into the house. We make it to the car and haul ass. We'll come back and get the package later.
What's wrong with you, huh? Really? Cut him. Cut his ass. Fuck him up.
If
you get me?
If he's a maniac. If he's like a mad animal. If he's like nuts.
When I nod my head.
If you nod your head.
You cut his fucking ass. Got it?
I got it.
Okay. Come on.
Maybe they're asleep.
There it is! There it is! There's the mailman!
No shit, and there he goes.
It's the man. He's got our package. Baby wants to fuck! Okay, alright, what's he gonna do? Oh, it's not a mailman, it's a mail girl.
That's okay.
Alright, is she gonna come up and ring the bell? What's she... What's up with that? What? Where's our package? One of us gotta go down there.
You go. My legs, they hurt.
Alright.
You don't think that, you know, have to discover the drugs, right? I mean, there's no possibility there's cops out there, right?
Come on, give me a break, Pete.
Then why don't you go?
Come on, what are you using for nuts, huh? That's stupid. You know what we'll do? We'll flip for it. How's that?
Okay.
We'll let fate decide, you know, depending on wind and motion and currents and all that shit, you know, I mean, not that it really fucking matters or anything like that. Okay, well, here we go. Call it, okay?
Tails never fails.
Okay. Oh, well, heads it is. Pete, you're on, okay?
Come on. All right. I'll go.
Stupid kid.
It isn't there.
Are you kidding me?
It isn't there.
Okay. I'm in hell. What is this? Is this some kind of joke? Jesus, what's going on, Pete?
What?
Tell me the truth. There is no package of drugs, is there? Is this some kind of crazy, unbalanced kind of shit of yours or what?
Sometimes they're late.
Can I ask you a question, please? Do I represent some kind of father figure to you? Are you trying to homo me?
Oh, you stop talking that shit! Sometimes the post office delivers packages late. It happens. It's happening now. They're late, AJ.
Well, what now, I wonder, do you think we ought to do, Pete?
We're gonna wait for him.
And what if this asshole comes home?
We'll surprise him.
Christ.
Me, Tom. What? What? Are you kidding? How much time do I have? Yeah, there seems to be a problem with a package that I mailed yesterday. I need you to put a trace on it for me. And please understand that speed is crucial. What number? Number. Yeah, 065697. Yesterday at 38th Street. What? Yesterday, 38th Street. What the fuck are you talking about?
All right, check this out. I found this this string, and I'm going to attach little bells to it. And I'm going to do this to all the doors. Now, see, if someone comes through this door, it'll ring these bells, and we'll hear them, and we'll respond accordingly, you know, by kicking their ass or running out the back, you know, depending.
Depending on what?
Depending on our reflex instincts at the time.
Mm-hmm. Well, I have a better idea. Why don't just rig a big, heavy object over the door, so when the door is opened, it will fall and break their spine like twigs, like a big anvil or some brick or something.
Sure, I'll do that later.
Holy shit, what the fuck is that? What kind of people are we dealing with here?
This is a Beretta.
Is that a Magnum?
Yeah, that's what it is, a 357. And it's loaded. This is a Colt 45.
Jesus Christ.
This shotgun was under the bed. These knives are, I don't know what, but they look expensive.
How do you know about all this shit?
Books, magazines about guns.
Why would these idiots keep this kind of firepower? This is not normal.
No. No, it isn't. But this is good.
Give me the bottle. Give me the bottle.
You know, I've just had about enough of you and your attitude. You know that?
Yeah, whatever.
I should give you a beating, you little faggot.
What did you say?
You heard me.
Your mother, AJ.
What?
Your mother.
My mother's dead.
Well, if she were alive, I'd fuck her. And she would let me. And she would like it. I'd fuck your mother good, AJ. If the bitch were alive.
You little...
Fuck you!
Fuck you!
Fuck you! That's good, man.
Yeah, guns are good.
How's it going?
Going? Okay.
All right.
Hot.
Goddamn heat. I can't stand it. Isn't there air conditioning or something?
No, there isn't.
Jesus.
And no fan. These people, there's something very wrong with them.
Did you hear a bell?
Hi.
Hi. Hi. Who's in there?
It's the girl. The girl. She's going upstairs. Hello.
Hi. How you doing?
Pretty good. What's going on?
Nothing.
Yeah?
Excuse me. What are you doing here?
Oh, yeah, nothing, really. I just came to pick up a few things for Wade in the hospital. It's hot, isn't it? I mean, it's really hot.
Yes, it is.
I think there might be some cokes left in the icebox if y'all are thirsty. I'll just only be a minute.
No.
Well, goddamn it! I cannot imagine what the two of you are doing here in this house.
Drop
really.
The gun.
Why? Are you two pricks gonna shoot me?
Yes.
I mean, goddamn, the two of you are sitting there watching the television.
Drop the gun. Drop it!
Willis, this is really absolutely something else. I cannot wait to hear what's going on.
I think there's some rope in the closet.
There's some hanging over on the wall, too, you fucking prick.
Tell her to shut up.
Shut up.
You two crap knockers got a lot of nerve.
Sit down!
How come?
Because I said so. That's why.
If I could have shot the two of you a minute ago, I would have. You would be dead and I would be happy. You ain't gonna get to do whatever it is you think you're gonna.
Shut up! You listen to me, woman. We don't care about you or your bullshit friends or your bullshit country ass problems. We're here on business. We don't want to be, but we are. Okay? You understand me?
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Good. Here. Get her feet. However, if you do piss us off in any way, we will not be remorse at all to absolutely kill your ass. Do you understand me, sugar baby?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Ask her if anyone else is coming.
Does anyone else know that you're here, or is anyone else going to show up?
Yeah, your parents.
That's very interesting. I'm going to ask you one more time. Does anyone else know that you're here, or is anyone else going to show up?
Not that I know of.
Well, thank you.
How are you doing?
We slept. We have slept. And it is the single most important thing that we do, that we stay awake. I mean, you know, can't react. You can't do anything when you're snoring with your fucking eyes closed. Peter, we ought to have been dead by now.
All right, we'll stay awake.
I mean, how can you handle the situations? How can you do anything? You don't know what's going on. That's terrific. Sleep is for pussies and for women. Men stay awake.
Listen, I want you to know that everything's going to be all right, okay? I mean, we're not psychos or anything like that.
Coffee!
Get in my bag. Smitty, watch.
It's lost in the mail. It's somewhere in the fucking postal system.
They said that if they don't get the package by noon tomorrow, your family is going to be lunch meat. I'm sorry.
Hi. We're not home right now.
Leave a message at the beep, and we'll be back. Thanks.
Pick up the phone, Cindy. Listen to me. Pick up the phone. It's me. Cindy, if you're there, answer the phone now. Hi, I'm Greg Sheele. Is Margo here?
Oh, Cindy picked her up this afternoon.
Was she alone?
I don't know. I think she had a car waiting outside.
Were there men? Men inside the car, men outside the car, any men, anywhere at all?
Sorry, I really didn't notice.
Thank you.
We got some questions we want to ask you.
I'm not supposed to talk.
Oh, you can talk when we tell you to talk.
What do you want to know?
Well, number one, how many people live here?
Just one.
Who lives in the other bedroom?
Wade's grandfather, Willis. He's dead.
What are you doing here?
I came here to get some clothes for Wade to bring to the hospital, like I told you.
What's he doing in the hospital?
What do you think?
Well, how the fuck should I know?
You sold it to us, you fucker.
What are you talking about?
You said it was good coke. That's what you said.
What happened?
Wade put it on the table.
Damn,
sober. He made shapes with it.
Come on, man, we're going.
He sniffed it. And then us. Me and Bo, we got no food. And then I started throwing up. Clear throw up at first. With bits of chunks of shit in it. And then more throw up, all bloody and weird.
What happened to Wade?
He turned pink and started shaking. I was throwing up. Allison was crying. He was running around in circles saying how he was gonna kill you.
I hate that thing. I love
you.
I love New York!
Shut up! Blood was running all down his shirt. He got in the car, and that's when he hit the people. I don't know if any of them lived. Five of them. But one was real little, so I don't know how much you want to count her.
Little? Like, what do you mean?
Like, only half the size of a full person. Little.
She was short. Like, she was a midget?
No. Little, like she was a kid.
You cunt. What the fuck is that supposed to mean? I asked you a question.
What are you asking me?
Well, what the fuck are you telling me?
You asked me a question. Why is Wade in the hospital? First, you tie me up. I answer you. He's in a mental ward. He's gonna go to jail. There's
you
your answer.
You fucking idiots. You're too stupid to know when you've been burned. You don't know the difference between coke and toilet disinfectant. You hillbillies, you come to my city. People get burned, they get hurt because of your outrageous fucking stupidity. I'm supposed to feel guilty.
Fuck you. Don't look at me like you know shit about shit, you whore.
She's up to just watching television.
She's a whore, that's what she's up to. When I was in the basement, I found a box with pictures in them. Can you guess what's in them? Well, I'll give you a hint. Her bush, her clam. She's naked.
What are you talking about?
When I was in the basement.
Why didn't you tell me about this before?
Well, I didn't think it was important. Weird part, though.
What?
Well, the weird part...
What is it?
Well, when I first saw these photos, I thought... Okay, fine. No, her and Wade, cute people, whatever. I mean, I'm a guy, whatever, but... They ain't Wade's. The pictures were taken by the grandfather. Pictures were taken by an old guy.
What? How do you know that?
Totally lewd pictures of her, naked, mixed in with all these grandfatherly mementos.
Really? The grandfather?
Yeah. Disgusting.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. That's how they are out here, Pete. They're sick, they're crazy, they're nuts. Perverted.
Pain medicine, super cortisone, great for work or home. This week in the pharmacy department, 50 applications for just $3.49, and you can also pick up a two-pack of cheese puffs for 99 cents. You won't find that deal anywhere else but Ann's Dixie Market, where good Southern people go, where? For good Southern food! 8 miles off Highway 99, near the stop sign.
I cannot tell you how much this school means to us. The very existence of the Republic of Mexico depends on the establishment of our foreign credit for the purchase of arms and supplies. We'll continue with the goal.
Come on there, boys! If you want fireworks that make an impact, there's only one place to go. Doug's Boomstand. Located on Cat Road on 595, Doug will tell you just about anything, just so long as it blows up.
Boomstand's got them all. So whether you're looking for something that snap, crackle, pops, bang, boom, blows your fucking child's hand off, you just gotta stop at Boomstand. Jack. Water.
Standing. And if you get into trouble with the San Manuelito authorities,
So, what do you usually do around here?
Nothing.
Well, what do you do for fun?
Get wasted and freak out. Why are you asking me?
No reason. Just talking.
Uh-huh. What's your name?
Fred.
Fred.
Yeah.
That's not your real name, is it?
No.
Uh-huh. Me.
So, how do you know Wade?
High school.
Why'd you keep all those guns up there?
In case of riots. He went a little nuts when his grandfather died. The house is haunted. It's made him paranoid. Why don't you tell me what you are doing here?
I can't do that.
Is your friend ever going to come down?
Yeah, don't pay any attention to AJ. Ricky.
It'll be our little secret, Fred. I don't want to be tied up anymore, Fred.
I'm sorry, Lynn. I can't let you go.
Why are you doing that?
It's a fucking mess in here. It gets on my nerves.
Are you nervous about something, Fred?
No, just don't like to live like this. That's all.
Why don't you come over here?
What?
Why don't you come over here right now?
What for?
I want to show you something. You can trust me, Fred. I want to show you that you can trust me. There's something I can't describe. You come here, Fred. Come to me.
Yeah.
Come here. You thought I was gonna kiss you, didn't you? A nice, big, wet kiss. Isn't that what you thought? My brothers could tie knots much better than the two of you.
Oh, my God.
That's right.
What the hell did you do?
I don't know.
You tied her up, man. Well, why did you shoot her?
Easy, boys.
Real nice. And now, I want to show you some tricks.
Thank you.
Hi, yeah, I'd like you to trace a package for me. Yeah, the number is 065698. Virginia.
Well, this sure is different, ain't it? Oh, we are gonna have so much fun. Let's see here now. Fred is Pete Gulley. Hi, Pete. Nice to meet you. And Ricky is Alvin J. Railey. I'm gonna have to tell you the truth, Alvin. I think that your behavior has been very rude.
Too bad, bitch.
That's one demerit for you, Alvin. One demerit.
Fuck you, sister.
Alvin, it looks to me like you want another demerit.
I hope you die.
That's two. Two demerits!
Come on, Lynn, what are you doing?
Didn't I ask you nicely? I asked you as politely as could be. I said, please let me go. And you didn't. It was selfish. It was bad. I should give you a demerit.
Oh, please don't.
How about, let's play a game.
What's the game? What's the game, Lynn?
How about, Alvin, you kiss Pete on the lips.
Oh, come on.
Fuck you, woman.
How about you kiss Pete on the lips and I don't call the police? Better still, how about, Alvin, you kiss him and I don't blow your head off? Go ahead. Give him a kiss.
No.
Now, I'm basically not kidding. So you had better listen to me. You kiss him right now or I will shoot your ass dead. Do you understand? Kiss him.
You can go to hell for this.
Kiss him.
You cunt.
Kiss him! Come on. Oh, goody! That was wonderful!
Thinking that men were coming who were gonna eat my skin, tear it off in sheets and eat it. I didn't know why. There's always all kinds of things going on that you wouldn't imagine was.
Jack, please.
People are always doing things you didn't think they were gonna. Do you want some, Alvin?
No.
I can make you do anything I want. You know that, don't you? Does that idea excite you? It excites me. Besides me, I could make you two fuck each other. I could teach you. You don't think I could? Well, I could. I could burn you with things, peel your skin. You would cry and ask me to stop, but I wouldn't. I would burn the two of you, and you would get erections, and I would make you fuck each other. If I wanted to.
Damn. What are you gonna do, Lynn?
I
don't know, but I think she's got one on it. What are you doing?
We're gonna tie her real good this time. Ah, here they are. I am going to use self-control.
AJ, calm down.
I am going to try not to hit her.
AJ,
I'm going to try this time.
Calm down.
Calm down? What do you mean, Peter?
Look, she let us go. She could have called the cops.
She's crazy. She's nuts.
She's
out of her mind.
We can't
just leave her here, Peter.
If the neighbors come by, she can help us out or something. Besides, in a couple of hours, we're gone.
Yeah? How do I know that? How do I know that stuff is ever
going to
come?
If we jump her, she's going to... She's scream. She could... A gun could go off. The neighbors here, and that's it. I think she's just sitting up there.
I'm just gonna, you know, go talk to her.
Sure. Whatever. There was no reason for what she did. Tie us up? Fine. Okay. I would have done that myself. But the bitch was playing games. Tried to make us homo each other. What I don't understand, Peter, is how this doesn't inspire in you some sense of healthy outrage. Please, go ahead. Go. Go and apologize. Tell her that you're sorry.
Is everything okay?
Stay away from me.
Are you sure?
Just leave me alone. I was wondering if I could go with you.
I don't know. Maybe.
Is it going to be soon, whatever it is?
I think so.
Can I sit there?
Oh, yeah.
Are you guys gonna be rich?
I'll be a little bit rich.
Well, I wish I was gonna be. What are you gonna do?
Well, there's some work to do, and then we're gonna travel a little. Well, I'd like to. I'll have some fun. I don't know.
I would buy a hotel in the desert and get a tit job and wear lots of tight dresses and carry a hip flask and be drunk all day long. Wouldn't that be fun? Good morning.
Yeah, sure, whatever. Would you mind telling your girlfriend... Excuse me, gender confusion. Would you mind telling Peter that it is fucking morning?
Are you mad at me, Alvin, for what I did to you?
It's here.
What's here?
There it is.
The mail truck?
AJ, how many... usually does it take to deliver the mail?
One.
Yesterday?
One. Yesterday there was one.
And it was a girl. You don't think...
I don't know.
Does he look like a mailman, or does he look like a cop?
He's a mailman. There are mailmen here to deliver the mail. Now, why there are two of them, I don't know. But they're mailmen, that's all, Peter.
I think he's a cop, AJ.
No, Peter, I think he's a mailman. He's a mailman.
Okay, all right then. You answer the door, okay?
No fucking way.
All right, we don't have to answer it.
Hi, mailman.
Morning, I have a package for Wade Wilson.
I can sign for it. Gee, I wonder what's in this package.
I don't know.
It could be anything. I bet it's sure something that I wouldn't want the cops to see, though.
Like what?
I don't know. I do not know.
Well, I have to go, miss.
All right. Here's your pen. You have a good day now. Is this what you guys have been waiting for?
Is this it?
Yeah, check it, see if they're gone.
Okay. Yeah, they went up the road a little bit.
Here it is.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Pete, I can't believe it, man. You did it, Petey.
Yeah! All right. Let's get the fuck out of here.
Let's just get out of here. Out of here and be gone.
What about me?
I can't believe it. Is it safe?
I don't know. Does it look like it is?
Well, it would. It would look like that.
What is it, man?
I think I see two guys playing frisbee up the street.
So what?
Were they there before the mail came?
I don't know. How would I know that? I mean, why would anyone be playing frisbee in this fucking weather?
Frisbee. Hippies. Pot. Lazy. Woodstock. Dalai Lama. Bullshit. Wait a minute. They could be cops.
They're not cops. Damn it. We're just fucking being paranoid. They're frisbee players. Let's just get the fuck out of here. Come on!
No, I got it. I got it. All right. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take these country magazines. Here. Take this bag. Go down the road a couple hundred yards. If they're cops, you carry nothing but magazines. Now go.
Fuck it, AJ. Why don't you go?
No. All right, we'll flip for it.
All right.
Okay?
Yeah.
All right, call it.
Tails never fails.
Oh, well, heads it is, Pete. Faith, he was meant to be you.
Damn.
All right, now remember, if they jump you, try to detain them as long as possible. It's better get your ass kicked a little bit, but don't panic.
It's not our house, not our drugs.
That's right.
All right. I'm just gonna go down there 100 yards, be right back in a minute.
We'll be here.
You'll be here, right?
Absolutely.
Don't go anywhere.
Of course not.
Okay, here I go.
Thank you.
Wade.
How you doing, Wade?
What the fuck?
Get here!
Come on! Come on.
No!
Get the fuck off! No! You fucking get off! Get off! Get the fuck off! Stop! Are you okay, man? Just shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Hey! Shut up!
That's what you get!
Shut up!
Why don't you just shoot him?
Did you make him shut up?
Right, AJ, we can't just leave her here.
Wait, what is it?
Someone in the house.
He doesn't know who we are. We're not there anymore. We're going somewhere else.
Right.
He doesn't know who we are. We're safe.
Yeah. Give me Officer Goldman. Greg, I need you to trace a license plate for me.
Man, this blood is starting to coagulate here. Fucking disgusting Gilly here.
God, that poor guy. You really gotta kind of feel bad for him, you know? He never even knew what was going on.
Wade? He never knew what was going on anyway.
Yeah. Fuck him.
So glad to be back.
Not that I ever got to see much of it, though.
Deli, you guys want anything?
Do they have microwave burritos?
No, it's a deli. They got chips, beer, and cigarettes.
All right, get me some beer, sandwiches, get me some smokes.
Get me some barbecue, potato chips, and beer, and chocolate cupcakes,
I only got
and beef
$4.
Jerky. All right, here, get me some smokes.
Here's a dollar.
All right, be right back.
Oh my God, look, there's a roach. Another one. Oh, this is disgusting.
I left dishes in the sink, that's why.
So, what do you guys do normally, Alvin?
You know, normally when someone calls me Alvin, I punch their lights out. Listen, I gotta change my clothes. I still got some of your boyfriend's blood on me.
Alright, alright.
Where? Where's the fucking bag?
My angelic cupid is easy. Hey, my angelic cupid is easy.
Hey, you got microwave burritos?
No, fucking door!
Cigarettes.
You got ID?
No.
What's wrong with you?
Just give me some cigarettes.
Did I say something wrong? Are you so nasty?
Oh!
What did he say to you right before I shot him? What was he saying to you?
He was saying, I have a bear and his name is Shmoo. And his face is blue, something, something, with Cindy and Daddy and you know, like some kind of nursery rhyme or something. He kept saying it over and over.
Why do you think he said that?
I don't know.
Oh, a little wishbone, I make a wish for a potato. Picking out the fish bones in my perch from Lake Champlain. Picking out the fish bones in my perch from Lake Champlain. Up tortillas, so much fun when you got a bowl of beans. Cooking up tortillas, so much fun when you got a bowl of beans. So much fun for the beans. When we make spaghetti, everybody gathers round and they eat it by the pound. When we make spaghetti, everybody gathers round and they eat it by the pound. They all gather round, they eat it by the pound. We fill up our guts, then we turn it into shit, then we get rid of it. We fill up our guts, then we turn it into shit, then we get rid of it.